watch.
Ah, so true.
I just wish it would burn when I pee.
Today on this genteel edition of X-Play, what's hotter than an Alabama summer? Why, hell, of course. And that's where Constantine... Plus, Airflip. Today on X-Play... We investigate video game violence and more games your mama wouldn't like.
I expect a number of horrible deaths tonight.
It doesn't get worse than this. So cover your eyes, campers. It's bleeding time. Mothers, don't let your babies grow up to be Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
That would be really weird.
It would be a little weird. So hello, concerned parents, and welcome to another blood-drenched edition of Games Your Mama Wouldn't Like.
For years, violent video games have been blamed for short attention spans, crime waves, and giving men unrealistic expectations about breast size.
Mm-hmm. Today, we once again sink to rock bottom to bring you more tales of malice and mayhem.
From a crack-smoking game that has parents' groups up in arms, to a game where a half-naked vampire fights goth demons, we'll be looking into the abyss and finding out if the abyss really does look back.
You know, if it does look back, does it wonder, hey, why is that guy in the ugly shirt staring at me?
If you only watch one show about video games this year, that's me you're talking about, isn't it? All right, well, you've probably already seen some other show that's on this channel.
But if you watch two shows, make the second this episode, and at least you'll leave disgusted.
And if you're a parent, I bet no video game disgusted you more than Narc, the brutal Grand Theft Auto clone that glorified drug use.
Well, I'm not a parent, but I was actually more disturbed by Disney Magical Princess. It makes all little girls look like bling-obsessed gold diggers.
Well, they are. Don't hit me! See, video games are causing violence. Here's a review of the controversial Narc.
All the glisters is not gold, kids. But if you can smoke it, pop it, or shoot it, you better get cracking before the Narcs beat you to it. What do you get when you mix equal parts Michael Madsen, Bill Bellamy, with the blood-borne contents of a kid at a Chemical Brothers show? If you answered a crappy game, you're right. Narc attempts to distract you from the idea that there may be a game somewhere with its near-constant barrage of let's get the pug stoned humor.
I'm telling everyone you're my bitch, okay?
Who would stoop to such lows?
Hi, kids! I'm Grovler, the crack squirrel!
Seems there's a new drug on the block, bringing dead folks back to the thug life. Liquid Soul is flooding the streets, and it's up to our fabulously flawed detectives here to get involved.
Oh, that's good.
We'll start in the city of lost children as either Marcus or Jack. Bill Bellamy and Michael Madsen supply the voice talent with Ron Perlman as the chief.
Apparently, U.S. law enforcement answers to a higher power.
Bleaksburg here is chock full of the sadly overlooked members of our great society. Take this bottomed out yet noble daughter of the night, distraught over someone named Richard.
No more Dick!
I hope you're happy, Richard. Dystopic visions of urban blight is nothing new, but Narc tries to up the ante by making the resident moral authority even worse than the local drug dealers.
You have the right to remain stoned.
Whether they're sadistically beating a handcuffed perp for info, popping pills, or huffing dope, these guys bear absolutely no resemblance to righteous lawmen. Now that the long arm of the law is tied off, let's hit the town in search of game. Run around an objective-based universe gleaning mission-furthering info, wronging wrongs, sniping, and the most brutal activity known in the gaming world, listening.
We underestimated their tenacity, that's all.
After a while, you'll kind of give up on the storyline as you continue to wage yet another stereotypical street battle to earn cred. The game's not all bad. It can sometimes teach valuable life lessons. Trade.
Hey, want to get high?
Negotiation. Never bring a bat to a gunfight.
It's on.
Side quests at times border on the surreally inane. Clouds of combatants only add a cluttered, trashy feel to gameplay. Auto-targeting is relatively responsive, but like a junkie's gaze, a little unfocused. The game's really banking on the frat house giggle of the drug effect. When our badge-wielding law dudes just can't take it anymore, they get high.
You should have laid off the ding-dongs after Reservoir Dogs, bro.
Even at $20, this game is more annoying than entertaining. The long-winded exhalation, we give it a 2.
Bye, kids. Remember, don't do drugs.
Out of 5.
It is a damn shame when a crappy game gets tons of free publicity thanks to overactive media hype.
At least the forbidden gaming fruit known as Grand Theft Auto 3 was actually rich and succulent. Narc's gameplay, on the other hand, is rotten to the core.
That was a very complex metaphor, Adam. Well done.
Thank you. Of course, not all conversations can be as full of poetic import as mine. Some deal with the basest of emotions, like lust. And this next clip is just disgusting and delightful.
Thank you for calling 1-900-NINJA-LOVE. A ninja will be with you momentarily.
Hello?
Don't waste my time. Let's go.
Damn, I like a ninja that can get down to business.
Want more?
Oh yeah, baby. You know who I am?
I don't care who you are.
I'm Link.
That's all you've got?
You know, from Legend of Zelda.
Pitiful.
Could you talk dirty to me again?
Forgive me.
That's okay. Well, are you okay?
I won't hold back.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I can feel the evil.
Oh, you feel that? Yeah, I feel it too.
Get ready.
Zelda!
Are you ready?
Yeah, just shut the hell up.
It's time for you to sleep.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll talk tomorrow.
Get out of my sight.
Thanks for helping me clean my sword.
What are you doing?
Nothing. Get out of here. Shut the door. Get out of here.
It's not really violent, but phone sex is probably something your mama wouldn't like. Unless you have the mama from Shortcuts.
Or unless your mama's a vampire chick in bondage gear, which is the kind of lady we'll be seeing after the break.
Up next, this dialogue not suitable for children.
Son of a bitch. You Nazi asshole.
The master can blow me.
Area 51, the secret is out. Game Informer calls it one incredible shooter. Electronic Gaming Monthly declares it could be your next Halo. The conspiracy is no longer a theory. Area 51, rated mature.
The Axe Effect.
Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, out now on Xbox. Rated M for mature.
That's the goal of the largest digital voice and data network in America, so you can be there even when you're not. The all-over network from Singular, raising the bar.
Buried Treasure is brought to you by EB Games.
Now here's a game that was developed over in Europe by Sega for the PlayStation 2. It was called Headhunter, right? Now, Headhunter kind of combined Resident Evil with like Metal Gear Solid. It kind of had some Splinter Cell elements in there as well. But the real story was Headhunter was actually the soundtrack. It's one of the greatest video game soundtracks ever written, in my opinion. It's done by Richard Jakes, big live orchestra. It was an extremely cinematic soundtrack. You could even play a girl in this game as well, so you could switch characters, you get on a motorcycle. So if you like games like Splinter Cell, Resident Evil, and Metal Gear Solid, you might want to check this one out. It's not as great as those games, but still very much worth your attention. I'm talking about Headhunter for the PlayStation 2.
Check out this and other buried treasures at EB Games. No cash, no problem.
Tomorrow on the G-Spot, Icons goes inside with the godfather of video games.
He invented video games, patents in his name.
Then cinema tech gets hard-boiled with the latest from E3.
I run these streets.
Find the G-Spot every weeknight starting at 10.
Not suitable for viewing by children. It's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Welcome back to a very violent X-Play.
Today we bring you another edition of games your mama wouldn't like.
And your mama certainly wouldn't like this next game because it features a half-naked vampire woman and more severed limbs than Evil Dead 2.
Here's a review of Blood Rain 2.
My God, look at that.
Good night, nurse.
Ooh, that's definitely stimulating my economy.
Do you like a little gratuitous violence in your softcore porn? Why, then you'll love Blood Rain 2, the game that proves vampires are really trampy.
Never forget that.
Oh, how could I when all the women in this game dress like this?
I've been working on something.
Yes, inappropriately attired vampire Rain returns for her second outing. But this time, she's not killing Nazis. She's killing a bunch of contemporary vampires who look like they robbed the local Hot Topic. And with the vastly improved graphics and ragdoll physics, the game is gorier than ever.
I expect a number of horrible deaths tonight.
And you'll get them.
Where's my backup?
Sure, there's a plot in this game somewhere, but it's not very good.
Dead God, Zerx, it's horrible.
But then, you aren't buying this for the plot. You're buying it for the killing. And the gratuitous underwear shots. And, okay, the killing. Don't mind that leg lying on the floor. That doesn't look very comfortable. Sure, you still have your handy-dandy arm blade, but this time around, you also have a gun that shoots, what else, blood. And the harpoon returns. But now you can control where you fling the bad guys.
I need help over here.
No kidding. You're on fire. The problem. There's also a smattering of Prince of Persia-style acrobatics that let Rain jump and swing on poles like, well, a stripper. Add to this Rain's delightfully genteel dialogue.
You lying rat-sucking son of a bitch. You Nazi asshole. The master can blow me, monkey suit.
And you have a game that takes the mature rating to a whole new level. Some of the in-game kills are so graphic, we can't even show them to you. So we covered them with kittens. Oh, so cute. Another nice feature is that there's no crummy item collecting in this game.
Switches and levers are so old school anyway.
The only resource is blood.
Don't stop. Oh, don't stop.
Ugh. Did I mention this game was intended for adults? Ooh, should have put that in gay games. Of course, the problem with Blood Rain 2 is that most of Rain's moves are totally unnecessary because the default slash gets the job done every time.
Now you saw the blades. What did you think was gonna happen?
Well, almost every time. On the groin, people. M'lady. No matter how much blood you spill, the bottom line is that Blood Rain 2 can get really repetitive. Even if you spill a lot of blood. Well, because for some reason the bad guys are chock full of it. It's like a sprinkler. If you're willing to branch out and try some of the more complex moves, you'll no doubt be impressed with how it all looks on screen. But while Blood Rain is pretty and pretty violent, it's also pretty shallow. We give it a 3 out of 5.
I'm going to destroy you.
No need to get personal about the score. Why don't you just go kill something? Aw, kitty. So cute. Hi, kitty. Meow, meow, meow.
This must be my lucky day.
Ah, yes. Believe it or not, the X-Play kittens get more fan mail than Sessler or I do.
These brave and adorably cute little critters cover up all the sex violence and rampant drug abuse we can't show you because the FCC would have us assassinated.
But there aren't enough kittens in the world to make Blood Rain 2 more than just a rental title.
And you can rent it at Gamefly.com.
They have hundreds of games to rent or buy, some of which your mama might even like.
However, one of the best violent games we played in 2005 is coming up later in the show. And while we know you'll want it, your mama probably won't rent it or buy it for you.
Sorry.
Up next, fun with chiropractic adjustment in Predator Concrete Jungle.
movies, music, games, TV. Everyday Verizon Broadband, the world's most advanced network, delivers a fresh edition of the accumulated wit and wisdom of the known universe. It's more than news. It's illuminating.
Mortal Kombat Deception. The only online 3D fighter for PlayStation 2. It will consume you. Available now. Rated mature.
Let's count sand. It's not.
Bean Farmer Extreme.
Let's wait in line. Awesome. This is all you guys have? Where are all the good games? You guys have nothing. Zip. Nada.
We have nada three.
With Gamefly.com, you can stay at home and rent games from the largest selection on the planet, and we'll send them to you. Go to Gamefly.com now for your free trial. Rated T through M.
On the next attack of the show, we put old toys to musical use at the Bent Fest, and Mr. and Mrs. Smith's Rachel Huntley plays in our LAN party. And we get bloody at the Fangoria Horror Convention. It's Attack of the Show.
We'd love to show you the world's next great video game. There's only one problem. You haven't created it yet. You've played them, now you can make them with DeVry's new bachelor's degree program in game and simulation programming. It's classrooms and labs where you actually create video games. Games like you'll find when you log on to DeVryPowerUp56.com. You'll learn more about this exciting degree program and get free video game demos from Vivendi Universal Games. It's time to take it to the next level. You can earn a four-year degree in less than three with classes that start right away. And since it's DeVry, you know you'll get this and even more of this. Call 1-866-DEVRY56 or go to DeVryPowerUp56.com for your free video game demos. But do it now, because when you're a gamer, you know what happens when you stand still. So call or log on for your free video game demos. It's right now, and it's here at DeVry.
Now rated TVMA, it's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Welcome back to X-Play.
Today we're showcasing more games your mama wouldn't like.
Games filled with violence, depravity, and an all-round lack of clothing.
What about a game taking two violent concepts and mixing them together, peanut butter and chocolate style?
Why, if you did that, you might have a game that takes a futuristic villain from an Arnold Schwarzenegger film and plops him down in the middle of a Grand Theft Auto clone.
Here's our preview of Predator: Concrete Jungle.
In 1987, a film of great emotional power was made in Central America. That film was called Predator. Now the Predator has returned to Earth in his very own game. But I am too busy running California to participate. Also, Danny Glover is not available. So it is up to you to play it. Now get to the chopper! Get to the chopper! What do you mean this game has no chopper?
To attempt to explain the plot of Predator: Concrete Jungle is a task so thankless that I'm gonna sum it up this way. It's about the Predator fighting hookers from the future. Oh. You play as an angry Predator with a raging drug habit. I thought Smack made you sleepy. Okay, I was wrong. Basically, you run through a city full of pimps, thieves, and some guys who might be Haitian. I can't really tell.
The law sends us blood. Blood to make our turf sacred.
Your job is to recover top-secret Predator technology stolen by these hooligans by killing and skinning them. No, seriously. So, basically, it's a game for kids. Anyway, the Predator spends most of his time taking advantage of the game's joyous ragdoll physics engine.
Why don't you hang around? Yes, I've still got it.
Along the way, you'll fight evil drug lords who are apparently former members of Cirque du Soleil. And you'll also get hit by tiny cars and make pimps cry.
Oh, no.
Okay. And maybe you'll even open a Predator chiropractic office. To accomplish all this creative carnage, they'll be using a variety of gadgets. No! There's heat vision, this green vision that confuses me. No! and binoculars.
Chopper!
Plus, you have a frisbee of death, arm blades, and a spear to make shish kebab with. Or you could just rip people's heads off. The biggest thrill thus far is running around the open-ended city stalking your prey. Oh, look, the old sex store, my home away from home. Ooh, and a local butcher who is shooting me. I have no idea what's going on here. Predator Concrete Jungle offers a sizable amount of content, an exhaustive combat system, and other exciting features. Expect a definitive review come this one's rumored launch in the summer.
It's not a rumor.
Okay, it's really coming out soon. Now sit back and bask in the warm glow of Ragdoll fun.
I'll bet good money that your mama still won't like this game when we review it later this year.
Oh, come on. It's about an alien fighting hookers from the future. That's clearly a family theme premise.
What kind of family did you grow up in, Sessler?
I was raised by wolves. That's why I'm so furry.
Doesn't explain why you dress like that.
In a moment, graphic violence and a threesome minigame. Your mama really won't like this one.
A warrior instinctively knows when he's found his perfect weapon. It's an extension of his skills. A reflection of his personality. It is the key that unlocks his deadly potential. Unreal Championship 2, only on Xbox. Rated M for mature.
Almost beaten my high score, and then the remote.
Something's
broke.
Never changed.
No. Look at this kid.
Hi, Spence. What's going on, man?
Hair, let me see
how you been?
Sharp,
buddy.
How's the army treating you? It's good. It's real good.
What they got you doing? Like jumping out of planes? Or...
No, I'm working with computers.
Computers?
Well, you could have done that here, right?
Yeah.
What's this heading?
0439 Zulu.
We're good.
Not really.
Get strength for now, strength for later. Learn more at GoArmy.com.
Nestle Crunch has always been loaded with creamy, crispy chocolate. Now, it's loaded with music. Pick up a specially marked Nestle Crunch bar and you could win unlimited Napster downloads for a year. 1,000 rappers are instant winners. Sit down to Nestle Crunch and get ready to download. Nestle Crunch. Why be playing when you can be crunchy?
You know what's insane? You can control the Black Eyed Peas with the push of a button. The music, the stuff, it all comes together right here. Best Buy. Thousands of possibilities. Get yours.
Miss America, there she is, your ideal. There she is, walking on air, she is. Paris of a pair, she is. Miss America.
Television's first digital beauty pageant, Video Game Vixens, only on G4.
Tree Friends is coming to Attack of the Show, Friday at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific.
Still not as vulgar as Deadwood, yet. It's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
If you're just joining us and wondering why your TV is splattered with gore, it's because you're watching X Plays More Games Your Mama Wouldn't Like.
All episode long, we've been bringing you gritty urban games filled with gratuitous violence. But now, we're raising the bar by bringing you some classically themed mayhem.
Yes, if you like a little scholarly whoop-ass in your literature, why not play a game that harks back to the days of ancient mythology for its subject matter?
This is one of the few games where you can claim, I'm not just ripping that man's head off, I'm learning something.
Here's a review of the excellent and excellently violent God of War.
After 10 years of suffering, 10 years of endless nightmares, it would finally come to an end.
Don't get ahead of yourself. We've only been on for 2 years. Like a thunderbolt from on high, God of War has struck the PS2. This Herculean hack and slash puts just about every other action game on the system to shame.
I will send you back to the depths of Hades!
This is Kratos. Even by ancient Greek standards, he is not a nice man.
Thank the gods you came back for me!
I didn't come back for you.
No!
He's tired of the killing game and wants to forget his past sins that have haunted him for a decade. So he strikes a deal with the gods of Olympus. They'll help him if he manages to kill Ares, the insane god of war.
And if I am able to do this, to kill a god, then the visions, they will end?
To do this, Kratos will slice and dice his way through legions of mythological beasties, and you'll love every single minute of it. A visceral, satisfying combat system dominates the gameplay. Every hit feels solid and meaty, and the action is enhanced by the addition of quick minigame-style sequences that let you finish off your foes with cinematic flair. And finish off other things as well.
Stay, Kratos.
Whoa! Severed heads and violent death is one thing, but bare breasts in a video game? Extreme! Watch it, you're gonna knock the... Talk about a blow to archaeology. God of War specializes in crossing lines you don't expect to be crossed in a game. Sure, you can hack at those harpies till they die, or you can grab one and rip its damn wings off. Whack a Gorgon with chain blades is great, but why not wrench its head off instead? Unfortunately, there's no follow-up command to down their necks. The game is full of over-the-top, uber-violent moments like this. Kratos isn't just a gloomy badass. He's a gloomy badass who'll beat you to death with your own arm. Then there are the boss battles. These exquisitely designed action set pieces are some of the most impressive things ever seen on the PlayStation. The downside? There's only 3 of them, and the third doesn't quite live up to the other 2. Occasionally, the action slows down for a puzzle sequence. The brain teasers in God of War aren't particularly difficult, but they're polished and brilliantly designed. They're so good, I didn't even mind that the first one is essentially an escort mission in which you babysit a wooden crate. It's impossible to recommend God of War highly enough. This is one of the most well-made action games in a long time. From the unbelievable graphics, to the movie-quality soundtrack, to the charmingly brutal combat, the only excuse for passing this one up is a weak stomach. It's on the short side, but we dare you to only play it once.
The gods of Olympus have abandoned me.
Maybe, Kratos, but X-Play gives you a 5 out of 5.
Now there is no hope.
Ugh. Somebody get this guy a live journal and an Evanescence album.
Oh, Kratos, you're so tortured. You actually start feeling kind of bad for the guy, as awful of a person as he is.
Bad, but I always thought, well, when I get upset now, I think about Kratos and how helpful it would be if I could rip somebody in two. I think it would be a calming experience.
I want to rip the wings off things.
Yeah.
It is so,
wings more than snapping.
Well, the wings have a sound. It's just so great.
Yeah,
and you get a room full of them, just
I just also like jumping up there and whipping the guys and smashing them on the ground. See, violence is good.
Yeah, it's really fun.
I think clearly saying that there's something very, very helpful. After a long day at work, go slaughter magical beasts. Like the whole blood pinata thing. I just think the game just feels so darn good to play.
It's very visceral. You feel like you've really hit something, which is so great. And the controls work so well, and the boss battles are amazing.
You know, Joe Lieberman is out there right now watching us say this.
Yeah.
And he's getting all upset again. He's
the steam coming out of the ears. Yeah. But the boss battles are amazing. The Minotaur, I think, is my favorite. I don't know. People argue about the Hydra or the Minotaur.
I think the Hydra was just so exciting when it happened.
All right,
maybe you have an opinion. Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
So then let us know about it on our website.
G40TV.com/Xplay.
I think that's it.
So go there and sound off
like I haven't been sounding off already.
Yes.
Okay. Now we're going to viewer mail.
We are. We wrap things up today with a letter from an actual mom.
They exist?
They do. It would be so cool if you guys did a kid-friendly games episode. My 3.5-year-old son loves your show. He gets so excited when it comes on. Plus, it's something we can watch together instead of having to watch cartoons.
I like cartoons.
I like cartoons too, but I can see maybe getting sick of little kids' cartoons.
All right, well, anyway, you're letting your 3.5-year-old kid watch a show. That's very impressive. Apparently somebody's not listening to the cultural troglodytes that are in the Parents Television Council. So there you go, though you may want to, we've done some naughty stuff today.
We have like naked people, we have swearing, we have bad things happening.
Just giving them good things early in life. Anyway, good games for kids, catch, reading. Yeah.
Is that a game? Reading's a game now?
Shh, if you tell them it's a game, they'll read.
Okay.
Sunshine. Sunshine's a good game. You go outside and you just like that, but you have to wear the sunblock.
Yes, well, obviously. Also, Pikmin's fun. Little strategy. Good game.
Pick the game. All right, everybody. We're back from commercial in 5, 4, 3.
You don't have a season pass!
Today on